In this lab, we are going to study Z transform. So the main objective of this lab is manipulate and measure the output of Z transform using MATLAB. As we have already studied different types of transforms like Fourier transform, Laplace transform, and now we are going to study Z transform. So how the Z transform is different from the previous transforms? We will start from the basic Fourier transform. There were two types. First one was CTFT, which was for continuous time signals, and the other one is DTFT. We can transform any time domain signal into frequency domain by using Fourier transform. For continuous time, we use CTFT, and discrete time there is DTFT, but there were some restrictions, like we cannot find the Fourier transform for a signal which is neither a power signal nor an energy signal. In that case, we have to find a generalized form of transform. So if the signal is not a power signal or an energy signal, in that case we used a generalized form of to transform, which was Laplace transform. And by using Laplace transform, we can find the transform of all the signals. In the same way, if we have a discrete time signal and we have to find that transform, or we want to analyze that signal, so we can use Z transform. Fourier transform cannot be used to transform a signal which is not a power signal or an energy signal, whereas Laplace transform and Z transform are generalized transforms which can be used. But both of these transforms depends on the region of convergence. As in the previous lab, we have discussed the region of convergence. If the region of convergence doesn't exist, in that case, Laplace transform or Z transform will not exist. So if we have a signal f of n, as we are talking about Z transform, so Z transform is used for discrete time signals. That's why I'm using f of n, and we want to transform it into Z transform. We will get f of z, or we can write it like f of z is equal to Z transform of f of n. If we further explore that, how can we find the transform for a discrete time signal, then we can write it like summation n is from minus infinity to infinity f of n z power minus n. So by multiplying the original time domain signal with z power minus n, and after summation from minus infinity to infinity, we can find the z transform of any discrete time signal. And in the same way, we can also find the inverse of Z transform, which will be denoted like f of n is equal to z inverse f of z. As we have gone through the generalized idea of Z transform, now we will see the implementation of Z transform in MATLAB. So first of all, we need to understand the basic idea. If we have a signal in discrete time and the name of the signal is f of n, by taking its Z transform we will get f of z. And here is the equation we have already discussed, that how can we take the Z transform of a signal. So there are two commands in MATLAB to perform or compute the Z transform of a signal. The first command is Z trans, which is used to transform a time domain signal into Z transform, whereas the second command is IZ trans, which is used to take inverse Z transform of a signal. For example, if we have a signal f of n is equal to 2n u of n, so after computing its Z transform we will get the answer f of z is equal to z over z minus 2. The most important thing before computing the Z transform, we have to initialize two symbolic variables. The first one is z and the second one is n, as we are already using symbolic variables for different kinds of transforms. In the last Laplace transform we used symbolic variable of s, and previously we were using omega. So in Z transform case, before computing Z transform we will initialize two symbolic variables, and afterwards we can use the commands Z transform and IZ trans. But the most important thing in Z transform is region of convergence. As we already know that we can find the transform of any signal, whether it is continuous or discrete time. If it is a continuous signal, in that case we will transform it by using Laplace transform. If it is a discrete time signal, in that case we will use Z transform. And these general transforms facilitates us to transform a signal even if it is not a power signal or energy signal. But the most important thing is its region of convergence must exist. If the region of convergence for a signal doesn't exist, in that case we cannot find the Laplace transform or Z transform. Previously we have discussed the region of convergence in Laplace transform. Now we will see how can we find the region of convergence in Z transform. Let's say we have a signal x of n is equal to 0.8 power n u of n. If we compute its Z transform, it will look like summation n is equal to 0, as we know our signal was multiplied by with unit step function, and unit step function has a limit of 0 to infinity. According to unit step function we set the limits here, n is equal to 0 to infinity, then 0.8 power n z power minus n. After generalizing this expression we can see here the expression will be 0.8 over z. If we have a value of z which is
less than 0.8. In that case, we will get the overall value of this expression 0.8 over some value which is less than 0.8. In that case, overall fraction will be greater than 1. And 1 power n, we will get a greater number or our signal will not converge. But if we have a value of z which is greater than 0.8, we will get the overall answer of this fraction, which will be less than 1. And by powering it to n, at the end this signal will converge. So we can say the region of convergence for this sequence is z is greater than 0.8, where the value of z will be greater than 0.8. in that case this signal will converge. And here you can see the z is greater than 0.8, only in that case the signal will converge. So in this way we can find the region of convergence of signals. Some most common Z transform pairs are presented here. For example, if we have a discrete time domain signal x of n, we will get x of z in z domain. If we have a discrete time signal delta of n, its Z transform will be 1. If we have a unit step function, in that case we will get z over z minus 1. If we multiply unit step function with any integer n, then we will get z over z minus 1 power 2. If we have a power n u of n, then the answer will be z over z minus a, and previously we have already explored this expression in the example. And if we explore the commands to take simple z transform, we will write it like z trans and then we'll pass the values of our time domain signal and symbolic variables. In that way we can find the z transform of our signals. Now we will implement pre-lab task to compute the z transform of a given signal. As we can see, the given signal is u of n plus n u of n plus n scale u of n. So whenever we need to compute the z transform, the first step will be to initialize symbolic variables. And in that case we will initialize two symbolic variables, which will be symbolic variables z and n. The next task will be to write the signal in MATLAB. The signal is u of n plus n u of n plus n square u of n. So we will write it like f is equal to Heaviside of n plus n multiply by Heaviside of n plus n Heaviside of n. So once we have computed our signal in MATLAB, we can see here is our signal in discrete time domain. Now we have to find its Z transform. As we have already known that to compute the Z transform in MATLAB, we have a command of Z trans where we have to write our original signal, which is small f, and our symbolic variable, which we have to pass through this function. By writing this way, we can compute the Z transform of a given discrete time signal. And here you can see we have a signal output in Z transform.